Now, we're going to say example one. Consider the following compounds. Which has the highest concentration of OH minus ions? What we should realize here is that all of them have two OH minuses involved. And because they all have the same number of OH minuses, that means that is not a deciding factor. So just ignore that. That means just look at the KSP value. We're going to say the one that has the highest KSP value would be the most soluble, which means it breaks up into the most ions. And the one that breaks up into the most ions would have the highest concentration of OH minus ions. So all we got to do here is look to see which KSP is the biggest. Here we have two that are to the negative 15. But this one is 4.1 and this one is just 1.3. So D would be our correct answer. Now, another way your professor could have worded this is, remember, associated with OH minus ions is basicity, right? So the more OH minuses you have, the more basic you are. I could have worded this as, which is the most basic? And you should have read into that and said, okay, he means most basic, so that means who has the highest amount of OH minus. I could have also said least acidic. Which of the following is least acidic? Which would have mean who has the lowest amount of H3O plus ions or who has the highest concentration of OH minus ions. Different ways, three different ways to ask the same exact question. And remember, because all of them had two OH minuses, we didn't have to look at the number of ions. We only looked at the KSP. If they had different number of OH minus ions, then we'd have to do calculations in order to find their molar solubility, which is X. And we'll learn how to do that a little bit later on.